गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल. इन टूडेज लेक्चर वील डिस्कस अबाउट द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ ASK. सो हेयर इट इज बीन गिवेन इन द क्वेश्चन दैट वी हैव एन अवेलेबल बैंडविड्थ फॉर 100 kHz विच स्पेंस फ्रॉम 200 टू 300 kHz. सो वॉट आर द कैरियर फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड बिट रेट इफ द मॉड्यूलेटेड डेटा BASK विद D इज इक्वल्स टू 1. सो वी हैव बीन गिवेन द बैंडविड्थ दैट इज 100 kHz. Now it spans from 200 to 300 kHz. We have been given that D is equals to 1 for binary ASK. Now coming on to the solution for carrier frequency, we will be having your half duplex as well as for full duplex. So we will be calculating the carrier frequency through half duplex and full duplex. Now see, we have a graph that is between your amplitude and frequency, that is in kHz. We know that the frequency is lying is ranging spans between your 200 to 300 kHz, which means we can represent it with the help of 200 and 300 kHz. Now see, we have the carrier frequency, it is situated at the center, so your FC will be in the center, that is your 200 and 300, so the midpoint will be your 250, so your carrier frequency will be 250 kHz for half duplex. If we talk about the full duplex, here we can see for full duplex it spans from 200 to 300 only. This is your carrier frequency, that is FC, that is 250 kHz. Now this rectangular wave, this is used for the transmitter side as well as this is used at the receiver side. So this will represent your transmitter and this will represent your receiver. Now here if we calculate the carrier frequency, that is denoted by FC1. So your FC1 will be 225 kHz, as well as if we see for this wave, here your carrier frequency will be 275 kHz. So by this we can calculate the carrier frequency for half duplex as well as for full duplex. Now if it has been given the bandwidth, that is 100 kHz. Bandwidth is equals to 100 kHz. D is given for binary ASK, it is 1. So we can calculate the baud rate. So we know the formula, that is bandwidth is equal to 1 plus D into R. Here D is known, bandwidth is known. So by this we can calculate. So we have been given bandwidth, that is 100. D is 1. So from this we can calculate small r, that is your bit rate. So your bit rate will be 50 kilo samples per second. Now by this we can calculate the baud rate, that is bit rate, small r is equals to capital R upon n. Here n is equals to 1. So by this we can calculate your baud rate. So your baud rate will be 50 kbps. Now coming on to the next, that is next technique, that is your FSK, that is frequency shift keying. So in this session I'll be discussing the outlines of my session R. We will be discussing the basics of your FSK, definition of FSK, spectrum and bandwidth of FSK, modulation of FSK, demodulation as well as its applications. Now if we talk about the basics, so it is basically used to convert the digital data into your analog data. So what we are doing, we are just converting the digital data into the analog data. Coming on to the definition, the frequency of the carrier signal is varied with respect to the amplitude of your message signal. Now we can see with the help of a waveform. Here we have a message signal where your 1 represents the high amplitude and 0 represents your low amplitude. So this is how we have been giving a digital data, that is 10110. Now with respect to that, if we talk about the binary FSK, here we will be representing your FC1 as well as FC1 frequency will be represented for 1 and FC0 frequency will be represented for 0. So here we will be having carrier frequency. Now this is the carrier frequency, that is FC1 represented for 1. And we have FC0, that is denoting your carrier frequency 0. Now see, your phi FSK, we know for 1 carry frequency will be represented as FC1 and your 0 will be representing the carrier frequency of FC0. So here we have FC1. So for FC1 we will be representing your FC1 frequency. Here it is 1. Now see, FC for 0, your 0 is representing FC0. So here the frequency of FC0 will come. So this is FC0 and here it is 0. So this will be your FC0. Now see, we can write your phi FSK, that is your phi FSK will be equals to your, if the message signal, if we talk about M0, so your M0T for 0, it will be, message signal will be M0. So M0T into cos omega C0T plus, if we talk about 1, so for 1 it will be M1T into cos omega C1T. So here we can see that your message signal MT represents 1 for FC1 and 0 for FC0 carrier frequency. So this is how we can represent our FSK. Now if we talk about the spectrum and bandwidth of FSK, here we can see we have a graph between your amplitude and frequency. In previously ASK we discussed the bandwidth of ASK. In ASK we were having the formula, that is bandwidth is equals to 1 plus D into R. Now here we have two band frequencies. First band represents for 1 and the second will be representing your 0. So this is for FC0 carrier frequency and this will be for your FC1 carrier frequency. Now the difference between both the carrier frequency will be represented by 2 delta F. So this will be 2 delta F. Now if we talk about the total bandwidth of FSK, so it will be equals to your 1 plus this frequency, this bandwidth, that is 1 plus D into R by 2 plus 1 plus D into R by 2 plus your 2 delta F. So by this we can calculate that this equals to 1 plus D into R plus 2 delta F. Now if we talk about the minimum bandwidth, if we want to calculate the minimum bandwidth, that is your D will be equals to 0. So for this we can say that the minimum bandwidth, this is your 2 delta F. So 2 delta F is equals to 1 plus D into R by 2 plus 1 plus D into R by 2. So this is equals to 1 plus D into R. Now if we put D is equals to 0, then we will be putting D is equals to 0. So by this we can calculate your 2 delta F will be equals to small r, that is your baud rate. Now if we want to calculate the minimum bandwidth for FSK, so for calculating the minimum bandwidth of FSK, we need to put D is equals to 0. If we put D is equals to 0 and we know that 2 delta F is equals to R, here if we put D is equals to 0, so in this equation, in total FSK, we want to calculate the minimum bandwidth, so we can put D is equals to 0. When we will be putting D is equals to 0, so 1 plus 0 into R plus your 2 delta F we have calculated, that is small r, that is your baud rate. So this is equals to your R plus R, that is equals to 2R. So here we can calculate the minimum FSK, that is 2R. Now next we will be discussing the multiple FSK. So for binary FSK, if you know L is equals to 2, L is equals to 2 means 2 to the power N. That means if we compare it with 2 to the power N, so it represents your number of levels. So your N is equals to 1. So your, it will be representing 2 levels because we have level, that is 2. So your carrier frequency will be FC0 as well as your FC1. Now if you talk about other cases, if we take other case, that is if your L is level is equals to 4. So if we will be comparing it with 2 to the power N, so N is equals to 2. So here we will be representing the carrier frequency, that will be your FC0. FC0, FC1, FC2, FC3. If we talk about L is equals to 8, that is 2 to the power N, N equals to 3. So here we will be representing the levels, that is FC0, FC1, FC2, FC3, FC4, FC5 and FC6. Now, if we want to calculate for binary PSK, here the bandwidth is equals to 1 plus D into R plus 2 delta F. So for here, if we talk about L level FSK bandwidth, if we want to calculate the FS bandwidth of L level, so we can calculate as bandwidth is equals to 1 plus D into R plus L minus 1 into 2 delta F. So we know that the minimum, for minimum bandwidth, your D is equals to 0. So by this we can calculate the bandwidth, that will be equals to your 1 plus 0 into R plus L minus 1 into R, that is equals to LR. Now next we will be discussing the FSK modulation. So in FSK modulation, we need to transmit FC0 for bit 0 and FC1 for bit 1. So here we will be having for FC0, it will be message signal will be M0T, and for FC1 it will be M1T. So we are having two message signal. It is multiplied through your carrier frequency, that is cos omega C0T and cos omega C1T. Now it is getting combining, these signal will combine, and here we have an interleaver. So basically the work of interleaver is to mix two signals and it will be generating your FSK. So here we can say your FSK, that is your phi FSK, will be equals to your M0T into cos omega C0T plus M1T into cos omega C1T. Now here we can see that in FSK it is a combination of your two ASK. We can see this is your first ASK and this is your second ASK. This is how we were having the ASKs. So we can say that FSK, it is a combination of your two ASK signals. Now coming on to the demodulation. For demodulation, we have two techniques, that is your coherent technique as well as your non-coherent. First, we will be discussing the coherent technique. In coherent technique, see, we have a signal, that is your FSK signal. It is multiplied through your carrier frequency, that is cos omega C0T and cos omega C1T. It is followed by a low pass filter. So here we have a low pass filter. And here this is low pass filter will be giving the information of ones, informations of zero, and this line will be giving your information of ones. So here we can see this is, here we are using a sampling, or we can say a sampler. It is used for sampling. Here we were doing the interleaving of the signals. In this demodulation, we will be doing the deinterleaving of the signals. After that, it is passed through a comparator. So basically, the work of the comparator is to compare which line is greater than. And here, after comparing it, we will get the message signal. That is your ND, that is digital data. So what we are doing, we are passing two carrier frequency with the received signal, that is your phi FSK. It is passed through your low pass filter. Here we are having a sampler, or we can say deinterleaving process. The low pass filter is giving the information of zeros, and here this line is giving you the information of ones. Comparator is basically used to compare which line is greater than. For example, if this line is greater than, this line has greater magnitude, which means it will be representing at the output bit 0, and if this line is representing greater magnitude than this line, so it will be representing your bit 1. So now coming on to the next technique, that is your non-coherent technique. So in non-coherent, we have a receive signal, that is your phi FSK. It is passed through your bend pass filter. So we have bend pass filter over here. It is connected, that is representing your frequencies, that is omega C0 and omega C1. Here we have an envelope detector. And after then, same thing we are doing, we have a sampler, or we can say deinterleaver over here. Similarly, we have a comparator. So basically in this, if the line has greater magnitude, then this line, it will give you bit 0. And if this line has greater magnitude than this line, so it will be representing at the output bit 1. So this is basically the FSK demodulation technique. If we talk about its
application. So it is basically used in telephone line modem. It is used to transmit 300 bits per second at two frequencies, that is your 1070 hertz and your 1270 hertz. Now coming on to the example, here we need to send data, that is 3 bits at a time, at a bit rate of 3 mbps. If the carrier frequency is 10 megahertz, we have to calculate the number of levels, the baud rate and the bandwidth. So it is the question, it is given n is equals to 3 bit, your capital R is 3 mbps and your fc, that is carrier frequency, is given 10 megahertz. So we have to calculate the number of level. So for that, L is equals to 2 to the power n. We know that. So we'll be comparing it with. So it will be 2 to the power 3. That is equals to 8. Now we have to calculate the baud rate. So your small r is equals to capital R upon n. So this is given. Capital R is 3. N is equals to 3. So it will be 1 megabaud. And similarly, we have to calculate the bandwidth. For L level, we know that for L level, your bandwidth is equals to L into R. From here, we know the level, that is 8. So by this, we can calculate the bandwidth, that is 8 megahertz. Now, coming on to the next question. It is given that we have an available bandwidth of 100 kilohertz, which spans from 0 to 300 kilohertz. So what should be the carrier frequency at the bit rate if we modulated our data by using FSK having D is equals to 1. So here we will be similarly as we have done previously in ASK. Similarly, we will be doing over here. So we have represented the two frequency bands that spans from 0 to 300. So here we are representing the same. We have represented two frequency bands that spans from 200 to 300. Here the carrier frequency will be 225 kilohertz, and here the carrier frequency will be 275 kilohertz. Now it is given in the question bandwidth, that is 100 kilohertz. So your 2 delta F will be equals to 50. Now we know the formula, that is bandwidth is equals to 1 plus D into R plus 2 delta F. So from that, bandwidth is 100 kilohertz, D is equals to 1, 2 delta F we have calculated, that is 50. So by this we can calculate your smaller, so it will be your baud rate will be your 25 kilobauds. By this we can also calculate your smaller, we know that is 25 kilobauds, and n is equals to 1. So by that we can calculate your bit rate. So your capital R is equals to n into R, so R is equals to 1. Small r we have calculated, that is 25. So this is equals to your 25 kbps. So this is all about your FSK. Thank you.